Nick Cordero, September 17, 1978 July 5, 2020, was a Canadian actor. He was nominated for the Tony Award for Best Featured Actor in a Musical and the Drama Desk Award for Outstanding Featured Actor in a Musical for his role as Cheech in the 2014 Broadway musical Bullets Over Broadway. Born and raised in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, Cordero graduated from Westdale Secondary School in Hamilton and attended Ryerson University in Toronto for 2 years before leaving to perform in the band Levemethod. Cordero's debut was in the title role in the off-Broadway production of The Toxic Avenger. He also played the role of Dennis in Rock of Ages on Broadway in 2012 and on tour. Cordero appeared on Broadway in 2014 in the musical Bullets Over Broadway in the role of Cheech, for which he was nominated for the Tony Award for Best Featured Actor in a Musical and the Drama Desk Award for Outstanding Featured Actor in a Musical. He won the Outer Critics Circle Award for Outstanding Featured Actor in a Musical and a Theatre World Award for the role. In March 2016, he joined the Broadway production of Waitress, playing the role of Earl. He left Waitress to join the Broadway premiere of the musical A Bronx Tale, playing Sonny at the Longacre Theatre, starting on November 3, 2016. For this role, Cordero was nominated for the Drama Desk Award for Outstanding Featured Actor in a Musical in 2017. In 2017, he portrayed the role of Victor Lugo in Out of the Blue and Heavy is the Head, the 4th and 10th episodes of the 8th season of the CBS police procedural drama Blue Bloods. He reprised the role in 2018 in Year 6, the 20th episode of the 8th season of the show. March 2020, Cordero was diagnosed with COVID-19. His wife, Amanda Klutz, reported that he was in critical condition, on a ventilator, and being treated with dialysis and extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, ECMO. On April 18, 2020, his right leg was amputated as a result of complications from his illness. As of May 1, 2020, he had major lung damage and had not regained consciousness after being taken off sedation. By May 13, 2020, Cordero had regained consciousness. On July 5, 2020, after 95 days suffering from COVID-19 symptoms, his wife announced his death via an Instagram post at 6:05 p.m., PDT. Cordero died surrounded by family at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles.